What's up, my crazy subscribers? This is DokingDown34 here, bringing you guys another Killzone Shadowfall multiplayer gameplay. And yes, we are still playing the 24-man domination game mode, and it's a one hell of a game mode because there's always action going around, and everybody's right there up in your face. That's what I like about this game and those kinds of, you know, game modes that are pretty much a bunch of people in it, because action's always happening, and you never get bored. Yeah, it's pretty much a choke game, you know, like I've been saying for the previous... I don't know how many Killzone Shadowfall gameplays I've been showing here, but that's what I always say. You know, this game is just for you to chill and have some, you know, FPS action. That's about it. So anyways, what happened in this gameplay was that I pretty much, you know, kind of saved the game. It was me and some other teammate. The reason why is because we pulled out one of the most important things you're supposed to have in this game, which is called the spawn beacon. Now, the spawn beacon allows you to spawn like in a certain spot wherever you place it down. As you can see in your bottom left corner of your screen, guys, if you press left on your D-pad, that's going to leave a spawn beacon. And every single one of your teammates are going to spawn there. Kind of like Battlefield. Kind of. So, what happened is, like right now, me and this other team are going to place down the spawn beacons. And once we do that, our team is going to have the advantage to make the comeback. Because now we're going to be dominating all three flags, and all we need to do is just stay there in the mid level. Because if we don't put down the spawn beacons, we're pretty much going to have to spawn all the way from base and then run all the way to the flags. And that's going to take a long time, and that's going to kill a lot of time, and we're going to be pushed back, and that's very bad. So it's not a strategy, though. Well, it is a strategy now that I think about it, you know. It is kind of a strategy. I'm going to give out my first strategy ever here in Killzone Shadowfall. If you're playing a whole 24-man deathmatch or domination game mode, someone must have a spawn beacon. If nobody has this, if nobody's putting it out, you take it out. You use a goddamn spawn beacon, because that's the only way you can be able to win, by spawning behind the enemy lines or midway, wherever the flags are at. That's very important to have, because if nobody has it, you're never going to win a game like that. The other team's going to leave one spawn beacon, and they're going to beat you like that. Yeah, with just one spawn beacon. So, to all the Killzone Shadowfall players, you must have a teammate with a spawn beacon. So anyways, another thing that I want to let you know, guys, the weapon that I'm currently using is different from the other ones that I've shown you here in my channel, which was on my previous three gameplays. I've shown you guys an assault rifle that actually shot real quick. It was pretty much, you know, strong and powerful. This assault rifle shoots a little bit slower, and that's what I hate about it, but it is very precise, you know, it's very accurate. That's why I have it here, and I called it the main weapon, but once I discovered this other weapon on the assault class, you know, I pretty much switched over to the other one, but I had to switch over to this one, which was support class, and pull out this weapon because it had the spawn beacon. You know, that's another thing you guys don't know about Killzone Shadowfall. It does have classes, support class, assault class, and sniping class, which is the one I'm about to choke right now. That's a sniping class, and you can turn invisible. Every single class has their own, you know, skill and technique. You can turn invisible, you can run faster, or you can leave gun turrets, or you can leave, another thing, air support. You can leave a bunch of things. That's very creative about this game. That's what I like. And, you know, still missing a lot more stuff, though. I want more weapons in this game. That's one thing they're really missing on. So anyways, going back into the gameplay, right here, I really did not see that spawn beacon, and that's what it allows you to do. You know, it allows you to spawn right there and then. You can be able to see it right now. This guy just spawns right there, another guy back to back, so that makes like 4 kills in a row back to back, and I couldn't kill this guy right away. I don't understand why didn't that happen. I mean, once you hit him with the rifle, I mean, they're dead. It's like a one-shot kill, just like when you knife in Call of Duty, or when you, like, pull out your sword on Halo, so... I don't understand what the hell didn't happen. So right now we're pretty much pulling the comeback, as you can see in the meters on top of your screen. We're pretty much already winning. We're winning like by a few hundred points. We're about to fill up the third quarter, and the enemy is still stuck in on the second quarter and a half. So yeah, I mean the comeback is coming right now. I mean we dominated by putting down those two spawn beacons. I'm guessing the enemy got too comfortable, that nobody ended up putting spawn beacons. I mean, look at them. They're just running around with snipers. Like, what the hell is this? This is not Call of Duty. That's what I hate sometimes. When we're, like, in tight stages like this, you don't pull out a sniper. This is not Call of Duty. So, I don't understand what's wrong with some of the Killzone Shadowfall players. Unless you're really chill. Unless you're, like, really just messing around, then I understand. So, yeah, you know what? I really don't care if you pull out snipers anymore, because, you know, this is just a kill... a chill game, you know. It's just a real chill FPS game, so I don't know, I just pull out my like FPS instincts right there and then. So yeah, I mean, I just pull it out, like, right there. I mean, I got a little bit mad, but damn. I miss Call of Duty, those Call of Duty days, man. So anyways, comeback's going on. We're almost about to win. Like, what the hell happened to the enemy team? They were winning so bad against us. And we finally beat them. I think they were a clan or something. I'm not sure, but they were pretty good. And they all had mics also, so I didn't pull out my mic because I really don't have any teammates to talk to, so that's why you don't hear me talking either. So yeah, right here we just need to capture just two and we're about to win. And right here, man, I almost got two kills. I don't understand why he didn't die. I mean, I had him on hipfire, he was like right in front of me. That guy's like pretty wide and I still didn't get him. So anyways, guys, yeah, I had to switch to assault rifles and I still did good. The overall record of this gameplay was pretty much 24-14. It wasn't that good, but I got a lot of action out of it. You know, I did ended up getting like a bunch of kills back to back, which was pretty cool and stuff. And you know, I don't mind this kind of gameplays. I don't care if I did bad, but at least my team won because, you know, of this comeback. It was a good comeback. Y'all gotta admit that, like, it was a good comeback. And right here, I'm trying to find out, like, who the hell's shooting at me? This guy right here. Check it out. Oh. And I got killed by that freaking gun turret. God damn it. So as you can see my spawn beacon right there. Everybody's gonna start spawning. You get extra points by that, by doing that also. Wouldn't that be cool in Call of Duty, like, if you left, one of those tactical insertions and everybody just starts spawning there? Actually, that will trap everybody. Never mind. Oh, shit. And right here at the end, suicide. Freaking a-hole, man. My teammate just stand in front of me and freaking a-hole. I ended up killing myself. Oh, damn. It happened a few times also in Call of Duty, so the tradition carries over to Killzone. Yep, I actually killed myself a few times. You can see that in funny live moments like in episode 5, episode 4, and episode 9. And I think episode 12 on the Modern Warfare 3-1. So you can see myself killing myself with a care package and some few grenades. So this is all for now, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the comeback. It was a good comeback. You gotta admit it. 24-14, I don't mind, but my team won like a badass. So leave a like, leave a comment, tell me what's up. If you guys want more gameplays of Killzone, please let me know in the comment section. So I'll see you guys later. And